children, in the last class we discussed about the difference between a criminal law and a civil law, right? Yes or no?
Yes, ma'am.
Ah, yes. What's the difference between a criminal law and a civil law? What's the difference? Any one difference? Anyone can say the answer. Any one difference between a criminal law and a civil law?
Ma'am, criminal law deals with the acts that the law say that it is an offense.
Okay. Criminal law, while the civil law says that it's an offense. Then what about the civil law?
Right to individual.
Right of individual. That means if any violation of any right, it is coming under civil law. Don't forget the difference, okay? Criminal law means if it's an offense, it is called a criminal law. And for a criminal law, then what are the other procedures? If it is a criminal law,
the FIR will be filed.
Yes, an FIR will be filed in the case of criminal law. But in the civil law, is there any FIR or anything is there?
No.
No is affected. They can file the case in the court. That's the main difference. And can you say an example for a civil criminal law?
Theft.
Very good. Very good. Then for the civil law?
Divorce.
Very good. Then the matters related to rent, land, purchase, purchasing of goods, etc. Okay, that's the last topic we discussed in the class. And today, the next topic, that is, does everyone has access to law? Do you think that every people have access to law? Access to court. Is anyone can approach a court?
Yes,
obviously, yes. All the citizens of India have access to court in the country, right? There is no difference among the people, whether they are rich, whether they are educated, whether they are then wealthy, or whether they are politically non-person. There is no difference among them. The court is accessible to all the people in our country. And every citizen has the right to for justice through the court. Every citizens in India have the right to justice through the court. But if they feel their fundamental rights are violated, any person, somebody is sharing the screen. So if anyone feel that their fundamental right is violated, they can approach the court. There is no discrimination among the people in the country. So a court is accessible for all the people who are living in the country. But in the practical case or in reality, it's not like that. Okay, so the question, does everyone have the access to court? The answer is yes, court, everyone can access the court. If anyone feel that their fundamental right or any of their right is violated, they can approach the court. But when we are approaching the court, what are the problems the people are facing? Do you think that is it possible for all the people to approach the court? Did they feel any problem they are facing when we are approaching a court?
Maybe sometimes.
Sometimes.
My family and all want support.
Okay. No, I'm not asking like that. In the court, if we are approaching a court, what are the problems there?
Ma'am, they need a lawyer. So poor people can't afford for a lawyer.
Okay. Very good. See, that is a major problem the people are facing. Money, right?
Yes.
Some people they don't have enough money to go and meet a lawyer. You know that if the lawyer is a very good person, his remuneration may be also very high, right? So for the common people, sometimes it is too difficult for them. The money is a major problem for them. Then only money. Think. For a case, if we are approaching the court, is any other problem is there? Money is a major problem the people are facing. Then any other problem? Why you are looking at the textbook? Please don't read from the textbook. You think and answer. Any other problem if a person is facing when they are approaching the court?
Ma'am, they need evidence if the law is violated.
Okay. Then? Children, I told you, don't think that whether what I am saying is right or wrong. If it is wrong, it's okay. We can correct it.
Ma'am, trust in lawyers.
We need the trust. Okay. Then if a common person, common people are approaching the court, what are the problems they are facing? The legal procedures. One reason is money. They don't have enough money for that. And any other reason is there? Any other problem the people are facing?
Ma'am.
Yes.
Maybe they have to wait for one case to finish.
Yes, very good. That's also a problem, right? It will take long time. Time-consuming process, right? For the court, if they are approaching for any issue, maybe it will take a long time for settling that problem. Okay, that's also a problem they are facing. So money is a problem. Time is also a problem. Why? Because it takes a lot of paperwork to complete. So it will take more time. So these are the problems that people are facing. And for a poor people who cannot, maybe who can't read and write, the poor people or the illiterate people and their family depending on the daily wages. The illiterate people and they don't have enough money. They are not ready to go for court for getting proper judgment in favor of them. Whatever the reason the poor people are not ready to go for court for settling their problem. The main reason is they need more money. And also it is a time consuming process. Right? You have a lot of paperwork and all, and it is a time consuming process. So the common people are not able to go and approach the court. So in response to this, or to solve this problem, our Supreme Court devised a new mechanism called public interest litigation. What is it? Public interest litigation. Have you heard about the term public interest litigation? Yes or no?
No.
No. Okay. So public interest litigation. This was introduced in around in 1980s. Public interest litigation. This mechanism was introduced in 1980s to increase the access of justice, to increase the access to justice. The PIL, public interest litigation, was devised by the Supreme Court in 1980s. Then, what do you mean by PIL? It is very important. When you are reading the newspapers and all, you can see this term, public interest litigation. That means it allow any individual or organization. Please listen here. The public interest litigation allows any individual or organization can file a PIL. Any individual or organization can file a public interest litigation on behalf of those whose rights are being violated. The PIL can be filed by any individual or organization. Any individual or organization can file a PIL, public interest litigation, in the court for others on behalf of those whose rights are violated. Clear? on behalf of those whose rights are violated. Maybe poor people, due to their illiteracy and lack of money, they are not able to go and approach the court. So most of the cases, their rights are denied. To avoid such problems, our Supreme Court come up with the public interest litigation. As per the public interest litigation, any individual or a group of individuals can file a public interest litigation on the court on behalf of a person whose right is violated. That is public interest litigation. This PIL, public interest litigation, can be filed either in Supreme Court or in High Court. It can be filed either in Supreme Court or in High Court. Public interest litigation, that means it is not filed for a person for his own need. Suppose if I feel any of the right is violated, I told you about the pay revision. After every 5 years, the state government employees' salary will be revised. So against that, a person filed a case in the High Court. Because due to Corona, the economic condition of the state is very worse. So it is there is no need for revising their salary. Such a case was filed. It's a public interest litigation. Is that person is filing that case for his own sake? Isn't it?
No.
It is for the society he is filing such a case. So such type of cases are coming. Then Rimala, I told you that case, it was by the woman lawyers, a group of lawyers. They can, any organization or any lawyer or even an individual, we can file a case in the court. We can give a public interest litigation in the court for on behalf of others if their rights are violated. And this PIL, public interest litigation, is filed where?
Supreme Court or High Court.
Any of the issues, okay, maybe related to pollution or related to road safety. Such cases, a person can file a case against the government. Maybe if it is against the government, they can file a case against the government in the court. They can challenge that in the court. And also, see, this public interest litigation's procedure is very simple. That means even a letter or an email is considered as a public interest litigation. There is no need for approaching the court directly. We can write a letter or even the emails. Nowadays, email are common, right? Not letters, is considered as a public interest litigation. That means its procedure is very, very simple. Its procedures are very simple. That is public interest litigation. It's a very common term that we are hearing when we are reading the newspapers and all. Once again, what do you mean by public interest litigation? That means any individual or a organization can file a case either in Supreme Court or High Court on behalf of an individual whose right is being violated. Then the legal process is very simple. Even a letter or a telegram addressing the Supreme Court is considered as a public interest litigation. And it is used to secure a large justice on a large number of issues. This public interest litigation played an important role in solving a lot of issues in our country also. An example is given there in the textbook, page number 61. All of you have textbook with you? In page number 61, four pictures are given. Have you noticed it? Four pictures are given there. That means it is before the, you heard about midday meal programs in the schools?
Yes, ma'am.
Midday meal program, midday meal. Giving food to the kids, free food to the kids, especially in the government schools. and in the aided schools, government schools and the aided schools, the food is given to them as free. Why the government takes such a decision? It is because of this public interest litigation. Okay, a person filed a case, a public interest litigation in the court, and finally the court verdict is like that. It should be provided to the students. And four pictures are given there, right? What is the first one, Fadil?
Drought. No water and animals are dying.
Yes, the first picture is shown a drought that happened in some of the, in the Indian states like Rajasthan and Orissa. And what happened after a drought?
Animals.
What happened to the food? Food availability. If a drought is there, sufficient food will be there?
No.
That we are seeing around us, so many cracks are there, right? Why such cracks are there?
No water.
Because of no water. So the same situation is there also. There is no water. If there is no water, what happened? What about the cultivation?
Less. They'll decrease.
Is it possible to cultivate anything without water?
No.
So if a drought is there, it will affect the people who are depending on agriculture for their life. And what happened to the food availability? They have enough food to eat, right? What happened to the food?
Shortage of food,
right, Tom? It is a shortage of food. So in the first picture, it shows that the drought that happened in Rajasthan and Orissa, and as a result, food shortage was there in India. And Pooja, what is the second picture? Pooja?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, second one.
Meanwhile, the government godowns were full of grain. Often this was being eaten by the rats.
See, in this one situation is like that. One place, a drought and food scarcity is there. In the second picture, what does it? The godowns. Have you heard about the godowns?
Yes.
The place where we are keeping the goods, as the stocks we are keeping in the godowns. And in the government's godowns, the Food Corporation of India's godowns are full of food items. And who is eating that food?
The rats.
The rats are there. Enough rats are there to eat the food. But one place of India, the people are suffering without food. Okay. Then Surya, what is the third picture?
I'm in the situation of hunger amidst plenty. An organization called the People's Union of Civil Liberties, or PUCL, filed a
People's Union of Civil Liberties. That's enough. Okay, they filed a
PIL in the Supreme.
What do you mean by PIL?
Public interest.
Public interest litigation. Yes.
Supreme Court. It stated that the fundamental right to life granted in Article 21 of the Constitution included the right to food. The state's excuse that had a duty to provide food to all.
Okay, so that is the third one. That is, a lot of protests happened in India, and what happened at a PIL, public interest litigation, was filed in the Supreme Court. And court, what court said? It is the duty of the Article 21, one of the most important article of fundamental right is Article 21. That is the right to life and property. So it is a duty of the state to protect the life of the people, and it include the right to food too. Right to life means only if we are eating proper, our life will sustain, right? You have enough wealth with you, but you are not able to eat anything. What happened to our life? If the people will die or alive?
Die.
Whatever you have, maybe you have enough. A big house is there, clothing is there, shelter is there, all other facilities are there, but you have nothing to eat. Money also with you, but you are not able to get any food items. There is no use for money there, right? So right to food, if right to life, the first important thing is the right to enough people, the right of every citizen is that they must need enough to eat. So right to food is also coming as a fundamental right. Right to food is included in the right to life. So the what the Supreme Court order, they rule the states, it is its duty to provide food to all. It is the duty of a state to ensure the food security. Then what is the fourth picture, Ken?
Ma'am, it therefore directed to the government to provide more employment to provide food at cheaper price through the government ration shops and to provide midday meal to children. It also appointed two food commissioners to report on to the implementation of government schemes.
Okay. So at last, what the court verdict is that it directed the states to provide the food grains through the ration shops. Through the ration shops, you must provide the food grains and also introduce the midday meal for the children. And also appointed a food commission to study about the situation. See, this decision taken by the Supreme Court is based on what? Based on a public interest litigation. So children, what do you mean by public interest litigation? Simply think, it can be an individual or an organization can file a case either in the Supreme Court or High Court if they feel, if on behalf of those whose rights are violated, okay? On behalf of those whose rights are violated. In this case, the public interest litigation was filed by an organization, right? What is the name of that organization? What is the name of that organization, Vaishnavi?
Ma'am, People's Union of Civil
Liberties. People Union of Civil Liberties. Did their right is violated, their children? Is their right is violated? Yes or no?
Yes, ma'am. Yes.
They filed the case for themselves?
No. For others.
For others.
For others, right. Here maybe they are from, they are filing the case for them? No.
No.
They are filing a case on behalf of others, on behalf of the people who are suffering from food scarcity. Clear? Why we are using on behalf of others? Here also, they are filing a case on behalf of others means here on behalf of the people who are suffering from food scarcity. They are filing a case. That is public interest litigation. Is it clear the concept? What does it mean?
Yes.
Public interest litigation. That means any individual or organization, they can file a case where?
On behalf of.
Either in, where they can file a case?
High Court or Supreme Court.
Either in High Court or Supreme Court. On behalf of
others
whose rights are violated. Here, which right is violated? Their right to life is violated because right to food is included in right to life. So their right is violated and they can approach the court. And the court verdict is like that. The right to life include the right to food. So it is the responsibility of the state to ensure food security of the state and give the food items through ration shops and also provide the midday meal to the children in the schools. Okay, clear? What do you mean by public interest litigation?
Yes.
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 Adikesh. Adigesh present. Please respond, children. Then I am sending the name. Bye, all. Next class, we can discuss the last topic. Okay. Bye.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you. Bye-bye.